Yikes. Random level up in the middle of the boss fight? Okay. But the first claw is done. This should make things a little bit easier. And the second one too. Okay, what's going on? What? Are you attacking or not? I do get the feeling that I should be level 8 or 9 to do some significant damage here. Yes! Shadowkeeper. Why not just call him Giant Scorpion? Giant enemy crab. And now we are only missing Australia. Thank you. Yes, we get it. It changes colors. Hooray, the chickens are resurrected. And the fisher. Alright, before we head to the village, let's take care of Mu and Polynesia. This should be one of them. Oh, got a knight. Yes, yes, I'm toasted, I know. Polynesia! Hooray! Nope, I didn't want to enter again. Okay, Polynesia is done, now Mu. Something up here? Nope. Okay. So what was the point of that? If I remember correctly, you can get some treasure stuff on at least one of those islands. I think a weapon or an armor? I'm not sure anymore, but... something. Oh, right. Something kind of neat that I haven't shown yet is the fortune teller. And she just predicts what's going to happen next in the story. And it's kind of an interesting way to help people who may be stuck in the game so they know what should happen next. Thank you. follow me to the huge hole. That's not suspicious at all. Before we leave, let's stock up on bulbs. And maybe talk to L one last time. Not sure if she has. Oh, yes. Aww. Sad scene incoming. It is kind of sad. And that's the point where you start to get emotionally invested in the characters. Which of course is good in an RPG, because without that, what's the point? Hole. What a great name for an area. Just Hole. Infinite pool with island continents. That's a pretty interesting description of Earth. What a story, Mark.